Welcome to the FTA catch-up on the XReal L2 Pro versus Viture XR Pro Part 2 image quality. The image quality of both the XReal L2 Pro and the Viture XR Pro is a very personal choice that might change from person to person. That said, there are some features that I will share in this video that might help you decide which one you will go for. Image quality. In terms of image quality, there are a few aspects to take into account. Some of them are refresh rate, brightness, and color accuracy. Refresh rate. Both glasses support a refresh rate of 60, 90, and 120 Hz, as well as the ability to enable color management in Windows 11. I couldn't notice a difference in performance while playing video games in Android and Windows, or simply watching videos on a MacBook. The quality of 3D videos when using the Viture Spacewalker app is really good, and there's almost no difference in terms of quality of the image when using the TV media player in the XReal Nebula app. If anything, the main difference is how easy it is to watch 3D movies in Spacewalker in comparison to watching 3D movies within the Nebula app. So I would consider both of them quite similar in this respect. Brightness. With a 1000 nits perceived brightness, the Viture XR Pro is effectively brighter than the XReal L2 Pro, which offers 500 nits of brightness. The XR Pro might be the preference for those who use the glasses under very bright light conditions. The brightness can also be controlled from the temples in both cases. The Viture XR Pro as an extra also allow you to control the volume of the music or the sound and see a progress bar to visually check how bright the screen currently is or how high the volume is. Color accuracy. Color accuracy is so personal that phones and computers all have different settings to allow managing the way the colors look. We can probably agree that there is a baseline that most of us would consider when comparing the color of different images. The challenge with this kind of glasses is that it is difficult to illustrate exactly what the glasses are showing. Despite this, I'm going to show you three images and will allow you a few seconds to decide which one you prefer, and later I will reveal what image belongs to what device. Please ignore the sharpness and reflections of the image and just focus on the color, if possible. Ready? Look at the three images. Which one seem to resemble better what you see from your monitor or from your phone? Do the blues look blue? Do the greens look really green? What about the reds? Do you prefer vivid colors or just a natural color? The Viture XR Pro, after the firmware upgrade that was released around the 4th of June, has shown a notable improvement in comparison to the original firmware. However, the XReal L2 Pro has been around for longer and still shows a more accurate color. Interestingly, and it might be subjective, but when using the Viture XR Pro in macOS, I couldn't tell the difference in color, and it looked quite similar to what macOS Ventura was showing. I don't know if there's something different when using macOS, or it was just my impression. Summary. The XReal L2 Pro and Viture XR Pro have both similar specs. Some of the differences related to the way the image quality is perceived are determined by hardware limitations and by software updates. For example, the brightness can't really be safely changed with a software upgrade, as it would be limited by the physical components. But the firmware updates and companion apps could, among other things, make the color more accurate in the future if the algorithms are improved. This is all for now. Thank you for watching and see you later.